How do you get business credit and funding for trucking companies if you're in the transportation industry? Well, that's exactly what we're talking about today. I'm going to talk to you about a lot of different ways you can get funding in the trucking industry, even if you have good credit, even if you have bad credit, if you're just getting started. We're going to talk about all different types of scenarios. I'm going to give you the actual funding sources, the actual lenders who can help you today. We're also going to be talking about business credit building specifically to the trucking industry and how you can succeed as well there, because it's a big deal. Like if you're getting fuel cards at Citgo and BP, Chevron, Sunoco, all these major fuel stations for $10,000, $20,000, $30,000, $50,000 limits, that's going to go a long way when you've got to spend $600 to $1,000 to be able to put fuel in your truck. So we're going to talk about business credit building. We're going to talk about funding. By the end of this training, you're going to know a lot of different ways to get funding for the transportation industry. We've got a lot to cover, so let's dive in. So I'm going to be talking to you today about business credit. And one of the things we're going to be talking about is how you can actually get credit for your business EIM without a personal guarantee, without an actual personal credit check. Now, if you're not familiar with business credit, we're talking about building a credit profile for your business that's not linked to you personally. So it doesn't matter how good or bad your credit may be. You don't have to have a guarantee. You can still get really high limit accounts to be able to fund your business. But one of the things to keep in mind and why it's a little bit more difficult to get money for the transportation industry, or especially trucking businesses, is that trucking is seen as a high-risk industry. Okay, now, there's a lot of things that deem an industry to be high risk. For example, one of those things is high risk of injury on the job, but trucking is seen as a high risk in AICS or SIC code. So again, this is one of the reasons that building business credit can help you. It's also one of the reasons we've got to do this training today, talk about all the different ways you can get funding, because it's tougher to get funding. Because when you are seen as a high risk industry as trucking is, then the problem is that it's harder to be able to come in and be able to get big conventional bank loans. And what we call conventional bank loans or traditional banks come from Bank of America, Chase, Wells Fargo, et cetera. Well, over 89% of business applications are denied by those big banks to begin with, even if you're not in a high-risk industry. And high-risk industries are subject to even more strict underwriting guidelines than other industries. So there's two types of high risk when it comes to industries and being able to get funding. There's ones that are just restricted, industries that you're just not going to be able to get money for. And some of those include pawn shops. If you're in X-rated or porn type stuff, those are industries that a lot of people just don't want to touch. You're not even able to get funding. Then there's ones that are just, you face more scrutiny in underwriting. It's harder to get approved. It's not restricted. Banks won't write you off and not do it. It's just, it's harder to get financing. So when we look at transportation or over the road trucking, we look at its stricter underwriting guidelines. It's not prohibited industry. It's not an industry that a lot of lenders just won't lend in. It just means it's harder to get approved than normal, and normal 90% of applications get denied. So it's pretty tough to be able to go through the big banks to be able to get money. So where do you go to get money? Well, national funding is one source you really want to look at. Custom tailored trucking business loan. Okay. They deal with other high risk industries as well. Working capital loans. Working capital just simply means you can get money for general purposes. You can get it for expansion. You can get it for marketing. You can get it for payroll. Like there's no specific purpose you have to use it for, like an SBA 504 loan. You can only use for a fixed asset. So if I'm going to buy machinery or equipment or real estate, it's a one set purpose. I need to use the money to get a fixed asset. Well, this is working capital. You can use it for any reason. You can get $5,000 to $500,000 in financing. You can get a loan with bad credit as well, because it's just based on you having consistent revenue. That's what they're looking at. They want to see that you have consistent revenue. If you have consistent revenue, you can get the funding without having good personal credit, even with it being unsecured, where it's not even collateralized by some kind of asset. They also have equipment financing up to $150,000 as well. So there's two different types of funding that you really want to look at with National. First is that they can actually get you working capital financing up to $500,000. They can also get you financing for equipment up to $150,000. Now, what do I mean by that? And why am I talking about that with trucking? Because equipment is trucking. So when you look at buying over-the-road trucks, for example, what you really want to look at is financiers that deal with equipment funding. They look at a large part of the lenders that deal with trucker loans or trucking loans, loans to buy big rigs. They're actually looking at those trucks to be equipment. It's equipment financing. So you can get approved with them also for up to $150,000 in equipment financing. They're going to want you to have 6 months time in business for that program, 575 FICO score. And you need an equipment quote from a vendor. So if you're going to buy a truck, you got to get an idea of what that truck is, the specifics or the specs on that truck, as well as the actual cost of the truck. But again, two different options for you from national funding as well. Now, somebody from Facebook says, this is why we do bridge funding or cash advances as long as they're owner operators. Yes, correctly. And bridge financing is a great way to fill the gap because, again, in a lot of cases, as you're just getting a business off the ground, you might not have enough time in business, enough revenue to qualify, and bridge funding is definitely a good option. And JLR Holler, thanks for listening in. I appreciate it. Jonas says, I'm looking to buy from my supplier at 45 days delivery against payment. Can you assist us buy from my supplier on that? It depends on what your supplier will do. So a lot of suppliers will give you net 30, net 45, net 55, net 60 terms. The best thing to do is just ask them. A lot of people don't even know that their suppliers will do that unless you ask it. But it really depends on the supplier. There's nothing I'm going to do as a third party to make that supplier do it. But if you just ask the question of the supplier, there's a good chance they may do it. And they may do it if your business credit quality is a certain level. So if you build some initial business credit, go to them and say, hey, I'd like to be able to get this on 35, 45, 55 day terms. In a lot of cases, they may look at your business credit reports to make that decision. We'll talk about business credit building today as well. And Larry, finally caught alive. I appreciate you tuning in. Jonas again says, how can I apply for working capital of up to 100 grand? Two ways you can apply. You can go directly to these sources I'm giving you today, or we work with all of them. So if you'd like to work with our team to help you through the process, just go to creditsuite.com/get funding. And it's at the bottom of my slides right here, creditsuite.com/get funding. You can also give us a call, 877-600-2487. Our phone number will be on the bottom of these slides too. So you just keep it on the bottom of the slides. You're going to see our link to creditsuite.com/get funding to get approved. You'll also see our phone number where you can actually give us a call. We'll talk more about getting you approved as well. And K-Tech says, what should you do right after you get this loan to make your payments lower? What would you say to them? Typically, when you get, if you want your payments to be lower, it comes down to two main things, term and interest rate. And by term, I mean, the biggest thing that controls how low your payments are is going to be how long of a term you get. Do you get a 2-year loan or do you get a 10-year loan? Big difference between those two. Okay, so for example, we got a 30-year loan for an SBA and our payment was $5,000 less than that for $350,000. But then we also got a $9,000 payment, twice as much for a $75,000 loan because our term was short. So we got five times more money and a payment that was half as much because the term is longer. So if you want low payments, you need to negotiate before you get the loan to get the payments lower. Once you get it, the only way you do it is to refinance out of it, which is not easy to do. But once you've proven yourself on loans like the First National program we talked about 80% of clients come back and get more money and they will then lengthen the term. So sometimes when it comes to this program we talked about where you can get up to $500,000, which is what you're asking about, KTEX, with this program, the key is to prove yourself. Pay back half the loan. If you pay back half the loan as they want you to, then they will give you a longer term. They'll give you more money and lengthen the term. So the next set of financing you get will have lower payments. So hopefully that helps you there. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about LVRG. They have several types of financing for truckers as well. Cash flow financing. Again, this is what we talked about with National, the first program. Loans up to $500,000 based just on how much revenue you're generating. Typically, they'll give you about 15% of whatever the annual revenue that is you're generating. So if I'm generating a $200,000 in revenue, I can usually get 15% of that, which is about $60,000 in an actual advance or loan. That's what cash flow financing is. It might be more than 15% in some cases, but it gives you some kind of guide of how much money you can get based on your current revenue. Okay, working capital where you can use it for general purposes. Revenue-based financing, very similar to cash flow financing as well. Business lines of credit, money that can be used and reused and paid back, not loans with set terms. So they do all of this specifically for the trucking transportation industry. They also offer terms loans, merchant cash advances, very similar to cash flow financing, but easier to get. Usually you can get this with 6 months time in business, $5,000 a month in revenue. And they're going to look at your credit card transactions, not all of the cash coming in your bank account from like checks and cash deposits, stuff like that. So if you have a lot of cash coming in the bank account or checks, then you want to go with a revenue lending or cash flow financing. But if you do a lot of processing of payments through credit cards, merchant cash advances sometimes work better for you there. High risk business loans as well, bad credit business loans, 4 to 12 month terms. So again, if you have really bad personal credit, they'll still help you. It's just the term is fairly short, so your payments are going to be high. And again, back to this point of how do I get around that? KTEX, what do I do? Well, then the easiest way to do it is prove yourself, pay back half the loan, and they'll give you the longer term. It's the best way to be able to get that term lengthened if they won't give you a long term to begin with. $10,000 to $500,000 loans. They will work with U.S. companies only, no startups. So you can't get this as a business startup because they're looking at your revenue. Okay, and we will talk about startup financing today, but revenue financing, you're not going to qualify if you're a startup because you don't have any revenue to prove. So you got to have revenue in order to be able to qualify. And whoever mentioned Andre, thank you for sharing. If you're getting value from this, hit the like button, hit the love button, and hit the share button. Let's help more entrepreneurs. We can only do that if we tell the social channels, hey, this is good information. Let other people in. So hit the like button, hit the love button. And just as somebody to hear on Facebook, by sharing somebody's name and bringing them in, I appreciate that as well. K-Tech says, thank you so much, brother. I love your videos. Thanks, man. I appreciate you coming in. And Jonas, I cannot send you an email because I'm not in a position where I could actually keep track of your email address. But if you give us a call or email us, info@creditsuite.com, we'll be able to get with you as well. And Barry says, give us some info on startups. We will talk about startups as well. So I'm going to get you some sources on how to get money at startups as well. Requirements for LVRG, 6 month time in business, $8,000 a month in revenue, bad personal credit's okay. And they also offer a second to fifth position loan. This is a huge deal. So what it means by second to fifth position is this. Remember I told you with cash flow financing, you can get 15% of whatever your annual revenue is. What LVRG will do is if somebody else already gave you financing for 15% of your annual revenue, LVRG will come behind that and give you another loan, a second loan, or a third loan, or a fourth loan, or a fifth loan. So they'll be able to give you a one loan that's behind that first position loan, helping you get even more money. Bottom line. So some one source gives you money, they'll come behind that source and give you even more money. So it's a way to get your money up beyond 15% of your annual revenue. Headway Capital, they give lines of credit up to $100,000, terms of 12, 18, 24 months. Remember, the last source I talked about with bad credit only goes to 1 year. They'll go to 2 years. So the longer term is what will give you lower payments. No prepayment penalty if you pay it off early. It's going to be state-to-state requirements are going to differ from state to state. You don't need to have great credit. They're going to ask for corporate tax returns, P&L, other business financing documents. But if you have that, there's a good chance you can get approved. So if we talk about Lendio, they have over 75 different types of funding programs, term loans, business lines of credit, SBA loans, MCA. So they deal with some of the ones that we talked about as well. They also have equipment financing specifically for trucking vehicles. And again, you can get up to $5 million because they work with SBA loans. 1 to 5 year terms, SBA loan terms are much longer. Interest rates as low as 7.5%, and you can get your funds pretty quick at as little as 24 hours. And again, they have lower interest rates depending on risk, and higher interest rates if you're higher risk. Kabbage, they offer trucking loans as well, up to $250,000 available. Securely link your business information online, and you're able to get an automated review. They actually use some artificial intelligence. Now, I don't know if I mentioned this or not, but somebody asked about startup financing. So I'll mention this in this place. There's also a great program called Credit Line Hybrid. Credit Line Hybrid. It's great for startups, great for trucking. We help a lot of truckers with this program to get the money that they need to get the business off the ground. And with Credit Line Hybrid, you can get up to $150,000 in credit lines, 0% rates for 6, 12, 18 months. You also, a lot of these credit lines report to the business credit reporting agency. So you're building business credit while getting the actual credit lines that you need to be able to grow the business. And on top of all of that, you're also able to get approved unsecured with no collateral, with no cash flow, even as a high-risk industry, even as a startup. All that's needed for approval is good personal credit, 680 FICO score higher. If you don't have that, that's okay. You can use a family member, a friend, a potential investor, a business partner. Anybody that does have a 680 FICO score can sign as a guarantor. Now, what's nice about somebody signing as a guarantor is that they only lose if you default and don't pay back the credit lines. If you don't plan on that, then they're not going to lose because these credit lines report to the business credit reporting agencies. So they actually show up on your business credit reports, even though somebody else was a signer. So it doesn't even adversely affect their credit because the credit lines are on your business credit reports, but you could still use their credit as leverage to be able to get financing. As a matter of fact, half of the people we help with Credit Line Hybrid are in that bucket. They don't have good credit. They're using somebody else's credit to qualify. So I wanted to throw that in here, even though I don't know if I have a slide later on it, because somebody did ask about startup funding. That's the best program I've ever seen for startups. $150,000 in credit lines up to, depending on how high your revolving credit limits are now, 0% rates for 6 to 18 months. You can get it as a startup, get it as a trucker, get it as a other high-risk industry. You could take the cash out of the credit lines as well. So a great program for startups that I think can help a lot of you that are watching out there right now. So Fundbox, this is my favorite credit line that exists today. You can get up to $150,000 with this credit line. They also offer term loans as well. But with our line of credit, you know, sometimes you can get approved for lower lines of credit without having good personal credit. For the higher lines of credit, sometimes they will want you to actually have a 600 FICO score or higher, but they're not really credit score driven. They're going to want you to be in business about 6 months. They're going to want you to basically how much revenue you have is going to determine how much money you get approved for. Typically, they will work with high risk industries. Okay. And what happens is they use artificial intelligence. So their technology plugs right into your bank account. And then from there, what they'll do is they'll underwrite the file electronically. So you can get a credit line same day. You can get your credit line and have access to credit line same day. It's super fast because they use artificial intelligence to be able to do this. Now, I love Fundbox because they're not really credit score driven. 6 months time in business can get you in the door with them. You can go to creditsuite.com/Fundbox, just like it's spelled out here. creditsuite.com/Fundbox to get approved. Here's some tips. Typically, they'll give you a lower approval under 10 grand. If you send them tax returns, they'll usually bump that approval upwards of sometimes I see 20, 30,000. Then if you use that credit line and you're paying it back about 6 months later, if you solicit them for more money, they'll typically bump your approval even higher. They go as high as $150,000 in approvals. Again, one of the easiest to qualify for credit lines I've ever seen for the trucking industry. Now, beyond that, there's another one called Bluevine. And Bluevine also uses artificial intelligence. They also plug into your bank account electronically to do the underwriting. They also do a same-day funding. They also do $150,000 in credit line. A little bit harder to get approved with them. They want to see 620-type FICO scores or higher. I found that Bluevine is harder to get considerably than Fundbox, but I wanted to give you two good credit line options there that will work for you in the transportation industry where credit really doesn't matter, but it does matter more to Bluevine than it actually does with Fundbox, just so you know. Barry says, cool, Joseph, amazing info and program. I don't regret investing in your services, Joseph. I'm really glad that you're working with us. I'm glad to be partnered with you. Facebook says, will there be a replay? There's always a replay of this on our Facebook page. If you go to facebook.com/creditsuite, you can access this replay. You can access this live right now, and you can also access our other past videos that we've done live as well. And cases slow down. Sorry, it's the way my brain works. Anybody that follows me knows it's hard to consciously pull myself back of the way I naturally operate. So hopefully you can keep up. I do my best to operate at a speed, but this is the way my brain actually works. So my mouth typically is just trying to keep up with the way my brain is. And Ann Watt says, I'm starting up a business. A lot of this funding can help you as a startup. Great content, Jana. I appreciate that. Ann Watt says, where can I start a trucking? Well, trucking industry, we have a lot of information on fundability on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/creditsuite. And that will give you fundability training. And that will teach you everything about setting up your business, getting your identity set up, getting your address, your phone number, your secretary of state, all those kind of things that'll help you get the business off the ground. And then this is a lot of the funding options that will get you the money you need to fund the business. If you need help, give us a call. Our numbers are at the bottom of these slides. And on a phone call, we'll do a free consultation. We'll talk to you about getting your business set up. We'll actually do a fundability assessment to figure out what you need to fix with fundability. We'll get your business credit reports for free with Dun & Bradstreet Equifax Experian. Go over those with you, give you tips and tactics to improve your business credit. And then we'll also talk to you about all the funding you qualify for now. So if you want some more help with that, about actually getting started, Emma, just give us a call, let us know. And it says the slides are rolling. I'm not sure what that is because it looks like okay on my end. But hopefully that I will correct as I work through this. So Gud Capital, they have trucking loans and transportation financing. They do bank and SBA financing. They also offer asset-based truck loans. So let's talk about this for a second. Bank and SBA financing is the same thing. You need to have good personal credit. You need to have established business credit. You need to have tax returns for 3 years. You need to have collateral to get approved. This is the hardest kind of financing you're going to get. Now, when I call this the three C's cash acquisition formula, so there's three C's you need to know about in order to get money for your business: cash flow, credit, collateral. So lenders want to see one of these three things: cash flow, credit, or collateral. We talked about cash flow financing, merchant cash advances, all that stuff that's based on your cash flow. We talked about credit line hybrid. It's based on you having good credit and good credit alone. If you have that, you can get financing. And we haven't really talked about collateral-based financing. Collateral-based financing can be using any asset that you have as collateral, whether it be commercial real estate, residential real estate, whether it be vehicles, whether it be equipment, inventory, 401k, stocks, IRAs, bonds, whatever asset you may have, that could serve as collateral to get money. And the trucking industry, obviously, the asset is the truck. If you're buying that, that's how we use equipment financing. We use the truck as equipment, and you're borrowing the money using the truck as collateral to get money. So cash flow, credit, or collateral. SBA, you have to have all three. So if you're not a really well-established business with really good personal credit, cash flow and tax returns, and you have collateral, to offset whatever you're borrowing, you're just not going to get SBA. It's the hardest kind of money to get. But if you have those things, you want to go SBA because they're going to give you the longest term. And by now, you know the longest term will give you the lowest payment. Okay, they also offer asset-based truck loans. Let's talk about this. Let's break down what that means. Asset-based means, again, it's collateral-based. Something is being served up and pledged as collateral. In this case, the asset is the truck. So what's happening is they're offering truck loans where the truck is the actual collateral being used to qualify. How much you may need down depends on other factors like time and business, credit scores, the truck you're buying, et cetera. And invoice factoring. Factoring is another term of financing that Bluevine offers, that Fundbox offers, that Gud offers as well. And again, what they do with invoice factoring is you typically will let your customers pay you on terms. So somebody doesn't have to pay you for 90 days, but that causes a hardship because you have to deliver the product or service to them, do the work, and not get paid for 3 months. Invoice factoring gives you up to 90% of that money right now from the lender and not have to wait the 90 days to get it. So the benefit here is you can let your customer wait 3 months to pay you. The lender pays you most of that money the next day anyway, so you still get your money. You make it easier for your customer to pay, and then the lender actually collects from the customer, and then when the whole payment is paid, you get the rest of the money that's owed to you. So in this example, if I'm coming in and getting 90% financing against my invoices, then I'm letting my customers pay me in 90 days. I'm getting 90% of that money in 24 hours. The other 10% of that money I get whenever the customer pays those invoices in full. So that's what invoice financing is. They offer this as well, and so do Bluevine, and so do Fundbox as well. It's a great way to go because it lets your customers have longer to pay you, which helps you attract more customers, but you can still get the majority of your money right away within 24 hours, so it's practical to make it easier for your customers to pay. Now, they have bank trucking loans, rates of 5 to 15%, loans up to $5 million. So we see this $5 million a lot, and I want you to know why we see that. It's because that's SBA loans. SBA loans go up to $5 million. So whenever you see lenders will lend up to $5 million, it typically means that they're talking about some kind of SBA program. That's why that $5 million you're seeing across so many sources, because they're offering SBA loans. Okay, 1 to 30 years, same thing. Whenever you see terms of 20 years or longer, they're almost always SBA loans. So I'm telling you this stuff because when you look up business loans online or trucker loans or whatever, they don't tell you what it takes to qualify. They don't tell you what kind of loan programs it is. So by knowing what to look for example, $5 million loan amounts, 30-year terms, you boom, click, you know that's SBA loans. Now you know you need good credit, cash flow, collateral to get SBA loans. So you can start ruling things out on what may or may not work for you just based on some of these things. Collateral is required. That means it's an SBA loan because you need collateral to offset the debt. And don't forget, if you give us a call at 877-600-2487, we work with all these funding sources, over 1,000. Today, I may show you 8. So just to give you an idea, we'll probably talk about less than 10 today. We work with 1,000 funding sources. So if you want to know all the money you qualify for, you don't have to memorize or know all this. Just give us a call. It's exactly what we do. We can help you through this process. But I want to give you some of the details of exactly what it takes to actually get started. Now, Janice says, I'm going to call today for my husband and I to get signed up. Awesome. For our separate businesses, trucking and real estate investment. That's awesome. And Jana, you don't even need to sign up twice. If you get started with us once, you can follow the steps for your business, and then he can follow the same steps for his business. And then you can knock out 2 businesses by working with us just once. So make sure you talk to your team member about that when you actually give us a call. So SBA trucking loans, rates of 5 to 8%. Actually, we just talked about this as well. Okay, and again, there's 2-3 types of programs they offer. These are their SBA trucker loans. Up to 25 years, loan amounts to $5 million, rates of up to 8%. Collateral can be the truck you're actually using. Asset-based truck loans, again, very similar because they're basically SBA loans. And invoice factoring is very similar with their requirements as well. So First Commercial Credit, they do invoice factoring. Now you know what that is. Rates of 1% to 3%, it seems really low. All invoice factoring is pretty much the same, 1% to 3% rate. So that's very typical for factoring. Get started in 3 to 5 days. Once you're set up with invoice factoring, all you ever have to do is send your invoices to the lender. And usually in 24 hours, next day, they will give you the money. So it takes 3 to 5 days to initially them look at like who your customers are that you're letting pay you on terms. They do business credit checks and stuff on them to make sure that they are likely to repay you. Okay. And then once that's approved, then what happens is when you get new invoices in the door, they usually fund them the next day. Okay. You can get fuel credit discounts as well, and you don't need any financials in order to get approved. Now, Fundera, they do semi-truck financing. If you have a better FICO score, you're going to get better rates. Terms to 10 years, that's really good term. So a good term of 10 years means you're going to be able to keep your payments low. You can't have any tax liens, repossessions, or bankruptcies in order to get approved. But Fundera is a really good way to go to get longer-term truck loans. If you're interested in buying a truck, they can help with that as well. HIL Financial, bad credit equipment financing, get specialty truck financing, refrigerated trucks, flatbed trucks. I'd like to see flatbed trucks too. Sounds delicious. So for refrigerated trucks, so if you have a specialty truck, they do specialty truck financing there as well. And this lender will ask for your social security number. They all are going to. I don't know why I added this to the slide. They're all going to ask for a personal guarantee. If you ever want to get away from personal guarantees, you've really got to focus on building your business credit. That's really necessary to get away from a lot of the personal guarantees. You're just not going to get away from personal guarantees unless you're dealing with some kind of collateral or asset-based lending and unless you're really building out your business credit. So some things to keep in mind. Fast upfront, unsecured business loans, secured business financing as well, which means they do stuff with no collateral and with collateral. Loans up to $250,000 are available. You can get approved with bad credit. You can get approved without a personal guarantee. You can get approved with no collateral as well. You can't typically do those together. You either are getting some kind of asset-based program that's supply, or you're getting collateral, something, some kind of asset is being served as collateral and you can get away from a personal guarantee, or you're going unsecured where you have no collateral. That's usually an almost all kind of financing going to require a personal guarantee. They're going to want bank statements to last 3 to 4 months, U.S. businesses only, and they don't work with startups. But if you have cash flow and your cash flow is consistent, they can help you. TopMark funding, 3 years plus business preferred. They will work with startups, up to $250,000 available in funding. Truck me must be less than 10 years old in order to qualify, and you've got to have a 600 FICO score. But if you have that, TopMark is definitely a great option for you to be able to get the funding you need to buy the actual truck. Remember, we're talking about a lot of options here. We're talking about options. You could just get credit lines. Just you can get general working capital financing. You can get financing specifically for the purpose of buying a truck. That's exactly what we're talking about here with TopMark. Now, Crossroads Equipment Lease and Finance, they are transportation equipment financing up to $250,000, financing up to 100% of the vehicle's cost. Look, we help a lot of truckers get financing. A lot of truckers get financing. Thousands and thousands and thousands. And I can tell you that of the ones, this is probably one of the best funding sources I've ever found when it comes to actually getting funding for transportation is Crossroads, because you can get up to 100% financing of the actual cost of the vehicle. I mean, that's you're not going to get any stronger than that. Okay. In cases, so who would you recommend as a fresh startup business? I would say, it depends on which of the three C's you have, right? So if you're a startup, you don't have cash flow. So now we've got collateral or we've got good credit. And if you have none of those, we've got business credit, which we'll talk about today as well. So based on you being a brand new business, if you have good credit, I go with credit line hybrid without a doubt to get general working capital credit line. Or if you have a guarantor that does. If not, you got to look at what kind of assets you have that could serve as collateral. If you have no assets and no good credit and nobody with good credit, then you'd want to build your business credit. That's to get you money in general to run your business. A lot of these other options I've talked about can work for you for buying the actual truck. If you're trying to get your truck on the road and get your truck going, again, a lot of these options will work. I've talked about options that work for startups. I've talked about options that work for bad credit. So you've got to kind of pick the one that's unique to your scenario. And again, if you're not sure, give us a call or go to creditsuite.com/getfunding. We can help you navigate all these to actually find the right source, but I'm trying to give you information on each one so you kind of be able to figure out for that your own unique situation of what might actually work better for you. And Barry says, sounds tasty. I love that. Yeah, I know. Flatbread trucking. That's what I think. That's what I said too. Okay, so clarify capital. Term loans up to $750,000, 7%+ rates, 6 to 24 month terms, secured and unsecured, which means they'll work with collateral and they'll work with no collateral as well. So some options there for you as well, especially if you're buying a more expensive truck. And then become.co, equipment financing, startup business loans, business lines of credit up to $500,000. And again, the requirements are going to vary lender to lender because they work with a lot of different lenders. But this is a way that you can get loans as a startup. You can get lines of credit. You can get equipment financing, financing to buy the actual trucks that you need, or the transportation vehicle that you need. And again, you can get up to $500,000 with them as well. Let's talk about veteran-owned business opportunities. If you are a veteran, then there are grants you can get from the Department of Veteran Affairs to be able to get your transportation business off the ground, okay? And it's done through its Veteran Opportunity or Entrepreneurial Portal. You'll have to meet each program's guidelines in order to get approved. But again, you know, it's free money. So it's something to consider. So if you are a veteran, these are great grants that you may be able to consider. And especially if you have a service-connected disability, you may also qualify for the VR&E self-employment track. So again, different programs, different incentives, different support levels, and funding, even grants that you can get if you are a veteran-owned business and you're getting into transportation or already are. So some things to think about there for sure. Okay, let's also talk about trucking school scholarships and other grants. So if you're still in trucking school or fresh out, if you're brand new to trucking, then you likely know that training and certification are necessary first, and you can find grants and scholarships to help pay for that training. Okay, some states offer grants to students who attend school, and you can check on a Pell grant as well. So there's specialized training that can help you with the certification and training you need to get the money you need to pay for that stuff so you can actually break into the transportation industry. So if you're just getting started and you're figuring it out, it takes training, it takes certification, then again, you can be able to get grants and scholarships. I know this because like I have this, I like to do like fun, cool things. And I think like driving backhoes and bulldozers, that's awesome to me. So like I actually looked into being able to get training and certified so I can learn to drive those things. Not because I'm going to do it for a living, because I think it's awesome to be able to drive them. And it's cost money. It's like $800, $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 for some of those courses individually. So for tracking transportation, it can be very expensive, the training and certification. So this actually allows you an ability to get the money you need to pay for that certification so you can actually break into the trucking business. Now let's talk a little bit about business credit as well. Building business credit will get you even more funding options. More funding options means you won't need to settle for higher interest rates or higher payments as well, or too short of terms. So again, you know, a lot of things happening with business credit. With business credit, you can start with starter vendors like Uline or Quill or Granger. You can even start with Wex Fleet type cards, but they usually want a $500 deposit, a personal guarantee if you start with fleet cards. Like Phillips 76 has a great fleet card you could start building business credit with, but they're going to want $500 at a personal guarantee unless you have about 8 accounts on your business credit reports. So you can start with starter vendors, Uline, Granger, Quill, those kind of sources. Buy stuff, pay it back on time or early. They report to the business credit reporting agencies. When you have about 5 of those accounts, then you can get to retail credit. You can get Home Depot and Lowe's and Sam's Club and Costco and Staples, Office Depot. You can get all kinds of like Amazon, Walmart, like credit at major retailers. Then when you have about 8 accounts on your business credit reports, you can get the fleet credit. And that's what you care about in the transportation industry. That's your Citgo. That's your BP, your Chevron. That's your Pilot Flying J. That's your Wawa. All those gas stations and fuel stations. If you want to get gas cards in general, like Wex fleet cards or gas cards individually per station, Phillips 76, for example, with about 8 accounts on your business credit reports, you can get approved. And you can get approved without a personal guarantee, without a personal credit check. So you don't need collateral. You don't need cash flow. You don't need good credit to build business credit. Anybody can get business credit if you follow those steps. Get vendor credit, then get retail credit, then get fleet credit. Then with 14 accounts on your business credit reports, that's when you can get Visa cards, MasterCards. That's when you can get auto financing without a personal guarantee credit check, computer leases for laptops and stuff you could take in your truck on the road. All of that with about 14 accounts on your business credit reports. Now, the purpose of this training isn't to teach you that in depth. If you want in-depth training on building your business credit, go to youtube.com/credit suite. And at youtube.com/credit suite, you'll find we have extensive training that maps out exactly the steps to build your business credit. But this gives you an overview. It's also a great way to go. The reason that transportation is one of our top industries that we service is because gas cards. That's why. Gas cards is this whole area of business credit. And for truckers to be able to get, you know, $30,000, $40,000 credit limit credit cards at places like Pilot Flying J, it's insane. Like we have clients that get $50,000 per week limits at Pilot Flying J. $50,000 a week you can spend. That's $200,000 you can spend a month at Pilot Flying J. So those fuel cards are essential to fuel a fleet of vehicles And again, business credit's the key to getting those kind of high limit gas cards without a personal guarantee and without a personal credit check. So to recap, trucking is a high risk industry. It means the rates aren't as favorable, terms aren't as long. Okay. If funding's available at all, you're really going to struggle to go through the big banks. So you've got to go with these alternative lenders. And we talked about a lot of that today. We talked about a lot. I talked about, I don't know, 15 different specific individual lenders that will help you if you are in the trucking and transportation industry. Business building business credit, it makes it easier to get all the kind of funding we talked about today. And it's its own way by itself for you to get funding that you can get regardless of cash flow, credit, or collateral. So it's a catch-all that anybody can get. And when you combine this stuff together, well, then it's going to help get you longer interest rates, better terms. It's going to help you be able to get more funding for the business because you've got fuel cards, business credit cards, credit lines, loans. You're putting all the stuff together. You can get the financing you need to get through trucking school. You can get the financing you need with no money down to buy the actual truck that you need. Then you can be able to get build business credit, get fuel cards to fuel the actual truck. Then you can get loans and lines of credit once you start to generate revenue that you can even come in, or even without revenue, even as a startup, you can use to fund everything you need in the operation to get the business off the ground. Then you can let your customers pay you on terms, and then you can get financing to get that money advanced to you right away, making it easier to attract more customers. I mean, literally, if you really think about what we just did, we just mapped out a financial strategy, an entire financial strategy for your trucking and business. Everything from getting you the certification, getting you the truck, helping you get the customers by letting them pay you on terms and getting your money right away, being able to get all the working capital you need and loans and credit lines to fund the actual business, being able to get the business credit. I think I mentioned that, to fuel the actual trucks and to be able to get all the other stuff you need. So this is really an entire financial strategy to be able to start and be able to grow your trucking business. And in case, of course, if we can help you, let us know. We don't charge you a dime of money to help you actually go get funding. Don't get me wrong. Lenders and credit issuers charge rates and fees, and we negotiate those with you to get you as low as you possibly can get. But we don't charge you a dime. It's free to work with us to help you with funding. We've got a business credit building system that does cost money. It's well worth it because it'll help you take years of business credit building and condense to months. But for funding, we don't charge you a dime. We'll develop a business blueprint. We'll tell you all the money you can get now. We'll help develop a strategy for you to get up to SBA loans and get more money as your business grows. So if we can help you, give us a call at 877-600-2487. When you give us a call, we will do a fundability assessment to figure out what's wrong with your fundability and then help you fix that stuff to become more fundable, to help you get more financing. We'll also get your business credit reports for free with Dun & Bradstreet, Equifax, and Experian. We'll go over those with you and give you tips and tactics to build your business credit. And then we'll also talk to you about all the funding you can get now. You might qualify for all kinds of funding. Funding to be able to get through trucking school, to buy your actual truck, to be able to get fleet cards. We can tell you about all that money you can get right now and qualify you for funding. It all happens for free on the consultation. 877-600-2487. Email us info@creditsuite.com. That's info@creditsuite.com. And you can also schedule your consultation online at creditsuite.com/consult. Did you get value? If you got value, hit the like button, hit the love button, hit share this with someone you know so we can help more people. And then also come back and check out our live streams Tuesday and Thursday at 1 o'clock, 11 o'clock on Wednesday. We go live on all different kinds of topics that help you get money for your business. You can also access our daily tips on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at the top right of our page, creditsuite.com. That's where all of our social channels are. We have hundreds of training videos on YouTube that will help you, especially if you're in trucking. We've got specific videos that will help you with all kinds of access to funding there as well. Okay, and we've got a podcast called The Business Credit Financing Show. And all we cover is half of its financial concepts. The other half is all kinds of effective ways to grow your business. How to exit with maximum dollars, how to start your business, get off the ground, how to build systems, structure, processes, how to advertise, where to advertise. All of that we cover on our podcast. It's the only place that I actually talk about growing a business, not just getting financing. It only happens on my podcast, The Business Credit Financing Show. Over 500,000 downloads. So very popular over-the-road trucker. You can listen on the go. A lot of our trucking clients do. And you can access our podcast and all of our other social links at the top right of our page, creditsuite.com. And my brain is frying. Great info. Great, Larry. This is going to be one. Look, this is going to be one you're going to need to play back. We covered so many specific sources here that you're going to want to play this back because there's so much information we've covered. But don't forget, just give us a call. We can do the heavy lifting for you. We can tell you all the funding that you can actually be able to qualify for as well. So let me make sure there's no other questions. Larry says, is this number only for trucking? You can give this. This is our main number. You will get to our team and our team can talk to you again. Transportation and trucking is the number one industry that we service. So we help a lot of people in the trucking industry. If you give us a call at 877-600-2487, Larry, yes, that is the number we can help you. And we can make sure that your questions are answered as well. So thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to check out our other social channels. Like and subscribe. And I look forward to seeing you on our next training where we talk about more cool ways to grow your business. Thanks for tuning in. Take care and have a great day.